City Palace, Udaipur. City Palace, Udaipur is a palace situated in Udaipur in Rajasthan, India. Built by the Maharana Uday Singh, it was one of the most tourist attractions of the city. Standing on the east bank of Lake Pichola is a massive series of palaces built at different times in 1559. The balconies of the palace provide panoramic views of Jagniwas, Jagmandir on one side and on the other side the city of Udaipur. Its main entrance is through the triple arched gate, the Tripola, built in 1725. The way now leads to the series of courtyards overlapping parishions, terraces, corridors and gardens. The harmonic profusion hard to describe. There is a Suraj Goda where the Maharanas of Mewar presented themselves in the times of trouble to the people to restore confidence. The Mor Chowk, Peacock Courtyard, gets its name from the vivid mosaics in glass decorating its walls. The Chinni Chitrashala is noteworthy while the series of wall paintings of Krishna are on display in beam villas. There are numerous other palaces such as Dilkush Mahal, Shisha Mahal, Moti Mahal and Krishna Vilas in memory of the princess of striking beauty who poisoned herself to avert the bloody battle for her hand by rival princes. Now the palace contains many antique articles, paintings, decorative furniture and utensils and attracts thousands of the visitors every day. The former guest house of the city palace, Shiv Nivas Palace and the Fateh Prakash Palace have been converted into heritage hotels. Hawa Mahal, Jaipur. Hawa Mahal is a palace in Jaipur, India. It was built in 1799 by Maharaja Sawai Pratap Singh and designed by Lal Chand Utsa in the form of the crown of Krishna, the Hindu god. It forms part of the city palace and extends the Zinana or women's chambers, the chamber of the harem. Its original intention was to allow royal ladies to observe everyday life in the street below without being seen, since they had to observe strict parda. The Hawa Mahal is an example of Rajputana architecture, which was strongly influenced by the Mughal architecture. It has 5 stories and is constructed of red and pink sandstone, highlighted with white quicklime. The side facing the street outside the palace complex has 953 small windows, and the breeze which circulates through these windows gives the palace its name and keeps it cool even in hot months. The entrance opens onto the courtyard with a double-storied building on 3 sides and one of the eastern wing with 3 more stories, which is just 1 room wide. There are no stairs to reach the upper floors, only ramps. Chittorgarh Fort. Chittorgarh Fort, located in the state of Rajasthan, was initially built between the 5th and the 8th century by the Mauri Rajput ruler Chitrangarh. At that point of time, it was named Chitrakot. Later, Sisodia Rajput ruler Ajay Pal Chauhan made more modifications in it. the history of Chittorgarh Fort was laced with the heroic deeds of the valerious Rajput nobles and sacrifices of the beautiful queens. The fort has witnessed at least 3 bloody battles since the time it was built. The first battle was waged by the Sultan of Delhi, Alauddin Khilji, in the 14th century after he had a glimpse of the beautiful wife of Ratan Singh in the water tank. He had so deserted by the beauty of Rani Padmini that he attacked Chittorgarh in order to possess her. The Rajput fought the evil intention of the powerful ruler with all their might and laid down thousands of lives so as to protect the dignity of the queen as well as the kingdom. Rani Padmini, along with numerous other ladies of royal households, committed mass suicide or Johar to escape dishonor at the hands of Alauddin Khilji and his nobles. The second time, the fort was attacked in 1535 by Sultan Bahadur Shah of Gujarat. During his attack, Sikramjit was the ruler of Chittorgarh. Bahadur Shah's army plundered the fort and forced the women and children to commit Johar once again. Rana Uday Singh, who later found the town of Udaipur, was still a young child then. He was transported secretly to the safe place till the time the situation stabilized. Later, he occupied the throne of Chittorgarh, but only for a brief period. The third attack came from none other than the great Mughal ruler Akbar in 1567, and Uday Singh was left with little option. He fled from Chittorgarh, which fell into the hands of Mughals. Today, Chittorgarh Fort is faced with little danger from enemies as it is an internal part of India. However, its history attracts countless number of visitors who love to hear the courageous deeds of its earlier occupants. Jaisalmer Fort. Jaisalmer Fort was built in 1156 and is the second oldest in the state of Rajasthan. 250 feet tall and reinforced by an imposing crenellated sandstone wall 30 feet high, the fort has 99 bastions, 92 of which were built between 1633 and 1647. Wells within the fort still provide the regular source of water. The fort built by Rawal Jaisal, which crowns the 80-meter-high Trikuta Hill, has its outer wall of palaces, houses and temples of soft yellow sandstone. It has narrow winding lanes and 4 huge gateways, the last one leading to main chowk dominated by the old palace of Maharwal. Almost 1/4 of the town's population resides inside the fort. It has approached through Ganesh Pool, Suraj Pool, Bhoot Pool and Hawa Pool. Also within it are many beautiful havelis and a group of Jain temples dating from the 12th to the 15th centuries. Thank you. Amber Fort. At a short distance of 11 kilometers from Jaipur, the capital of Rajasthan state, the Amber Fort complex stands amidst wooded hills overlooking the Delhi-Jaipur highway, which is forbidding ramparts reflecting in the still waters of the Mawota lake below. One of the finest examples of Rajput architecture, it was the ancient capital of Kachwa rulers. The original palace was built by Raja Man Singh and additions were made later by Savai Jai Singh. Within the palace are the Diwan-e-Aam or the Hall of Public Audience, the Diwan-e-Khas or the Hall of Private Audience and the Sukhnevs, where the cool breeze blows across channels of water for the purpose of air conditioning. The private chambers of the queens have windows with latticed screens so that the ladies could watch the proceedings of the royal court in privacy. There is also a Jai Mandir or the Temple of Victory with its famous Sheesh Mahal, the scintillating hall of mirrors. Lake Palace. The Taj Lake Palace, located in the middle of Lake Pikhola, is a dream of white marble and mosaic glistening in the moonlight. Very reminiscent of the most beautiful tourist click in the world, the Taj Mahal. Conceived in romance, the palace was built in 1746 by Maharaja Rajat Singh II, 62nd successor to the royal dynasty of Mewar, believed to be the descendants of the sun god. Set against the backdrop of the majestic Aravalli Mountains on one side of the lake, the lofty palace on the other side, the Taj Lake Palace spread across the 4-acre land, an almost surreal vision in marble. The royal butlers, descendants of the original palace retainers, look after all the contemporary comforts and ensure that all guests are treated like royalty. Umaid Bhawan Palace. Umaid Bhawan Palace, located at Jodhpur in Rajasthan, India, is one of the world's largest private residences. A part of the palace is managed by Taj Hotels, named after Maharaja Umaid Singh, grandfather of the present owners of the palace. This monument has 347 rooms and serves as a principal residence of the erstwhile Jodhpur royal family. Umaid Bhawan Palace was called Chitar Palace during its construction due to its location on Chitar Hill, the highest point of Jodhpur. Ground for the foundations of the building was broken on 18 November 1929 by Maharaja Umaid Singh, and the construction work was completed in 1943. Uttar Pradesh.